I can't believe you didn't leave that rolling. I've literally just finished the tape, waffling about all things to do with watercraft. And like, this is like screamed off. First fish on new rod. Oh, I'm well excited. That is lovely. So we've got the 11-foot Superior SL proper. Love that. On the pellet cone. So we've had two on the method, and then it's gone quiet for sort of half an hour. So I've chucked a pellet cone, miles away really from where I was chucking the method, to my left, just covering a fish that I saw bosh out. And it's gone within sort of like 10 minutes, I suppose. So I'm going to talk you lovely lot through the pellet cone and all its properties. It's a brilliant tactic, more so for like when it's proper clear, because obviously, you and the fishes, more so for like when it's proper clear, because as you'll see in a bit when I demonstrate, there's nothing there to spook the fish, or spook the fish, as they say in Yorkshire. You know what I mean? Look at that, that's beautiful. What are you giving me for that? I'm going to say that is, hang on, let me get Duke out, perfectly Duked in the bottom lip. I mean, that was in, that were never coming out. Come on! Here we are, he's out. I'm going to give myself, it's like a ghosty comedy thing, I'm going to give myself 4 pounds and 2 ounces. Nice and. Right, just bear with me, folks, I'll just get him in the net, and then I'm going to talk you through what I mean about this pellet cone. We'll do it in one. So, I'm going to change this hook length. I've not actually prepared one, but I will do, so we can do it all in one. Because we like doing it all in one. So this is the beauty of this pellet cone, is that I can change that hook length, put another one on, and be nice and quick straight back into the fish. But because I was talking before, I didn't actually have a chance to prepare one. So what I'll do now is prepare one for you. So we can have that in there, and then we can talk you through this pellet cone. So basically, my favourite bait to put on with a pellet cone is just a simple hairy corn. For me, I don't think you can beat it for a winter bait. I can't stand using bread. I proper hate using bread. It bothers me. It's like, bread's not on, bread's not on. Fishing's all about having confidence. And if you've not got confidence that your bait's not on, then it's just up there. And every time, obviously, I go to wind back, there's no blooming bread on. I know it's going to be on, but it's just one of them. If you're not confident in something, don't fish it, because it won't give you confidence in the long run. So I've got a little spiker on the end there, just in a loop. I've put the corn on with a bait spike, and we've got a 16s KKM, and we're on 0.16 line. To be fair, it doesn't really make a blind bit of difference what diameter line you use. I won't go any lighter than 0.16. Quite often I'd use 0.18 or 0.20. I'll always fish with like an 18-inch hook length, and I'll show you that business at the other end in a bit, but basically it's a 6-inch twizzle boom with like a swivelly, hook-changey, quick thing, a quick release. I don't even know what they're called. I always forget what they're called, folks, but I'll show you what I mean in a bit. So basically, we've got that. That's all ready to go. The next thing is to get... Now, all these are... I've got another one in here. Let me get this out here. All these are... is... Remember the old style? Like, no one uses them anymore. Well, natural anglers do. It's basically the pole bungs that go on the inside of your pole to store the elastic. All I've done is just chopped them down, so I've got like a bigger rule one and a smaller rule one. Then all you're doing, you're plugging it like a feeder. So you're plugging your micros in that like a feeder, and then what you'll have is you'll have a narrow end and a thicker end. So basically all we're doing with a trap gate baiting needle thing, I forgot what that was called then, you're going through the thin end. So that's going right through the middle, through the pellets, and comes out there. And then you're getting your hook length. Fantastic way of fishing, folks, it really is. You're getting your hook length, got a little loop in there, and you're just attaching that to the loop, close the gate. Oh wow, blooming fidgety hands. Right, close it. Oh, it blooming fell off again. I will get it for you, folks. Hang on. There you go, that's in the loop. Let me close it. It's on. And then you're sliding that down, pulling it through. That gets rested on there, and then you literally just easing this out, so get your little finger on it, and then that'll just fold out like that. So that's what you're left with. Now, this is the beauty of the pellet cone over, say, a method or a pellet feeder, something like that, where when the water's clear, obviously with a method, let me get a method out for you. So if you can imagine a method on the ground there, fish can see that. You know, obviously you've only got a little babby up length on, so the fish can see that, and it's going to put them off. It's going to spook them. So that's why the beauty of pellet cone imagine that when it breaks out in sort of like the size of a tea bag, and you've just got your bright visible piece of yellow corn on, there's nothing untoward there, because your ledger bombs like over here somewhere, because we've got an 18 inch up length on with, let me show you now, I can go through the setup. So we've got an 18 inch up length on, and then we've got this bit of twizzled lines. We've got like what, 6 inches of twizzled line, and then we've got one of them quick changey swivelly hook changey swivelly things. I don't even know what they're called, but basically that alleviates obviously your hook spins. You won't get any hook spins, but you can change your hook length in one, so when you come back, hopefully after landing a great big fish, put your new one on, then you're straight back in business again. So I could have been, if I wasn't talking to you a lot, I could have been fishing dead quick then, you know what I mean? And obviously match conditions, that's what you want. In matches, I'll have sort of 3 or 4 of these on the go, ready to go, because when they rock up, you can do a silly weight in a short space of time. So all I'm doing is I'm just attaching that to the hook lengthy, changey, swivelly, hooky thing, pull the rubber grommet down over it. So basically, as that lands in the water, you want to make sure when you cast it, it's more of a lob than a cast. If you cast too hard, your pellet's going to fall off. So it's more of a lob. That's why a soft rod's ideal for this style of fishing. That lands in, you want to make sure you get a double plop. So it's landing in like that. Bombs over there, ledger bombs over there somewhere in the silt. And then that is just above the silt. It's dead light. Nice little package of food. Fish sees a yellow corn, nails it, and you're in. It's an awesome way of fishing. I definitely, definitely recommend you give it a try. The other thing I've got on is just a little rubber float stop just on the main line, and I've just got a snap link swivel to a ledger bomb. Heavier bombs are better for setting the hook and obviously aiding your casting, because I say you don't really want to sort of like welly your left hand through when you're casting. It's more of a lob, which I shall demonstrate now. So basically, get that down there, wind that up, so we've got a nice long drop, a nice sort of like 5 foot drop, and then say it's more of a lob. So swing it out first, and then it's more of a lob than a cast. So bring that back, look for the double plop. Oh, we've got a double plop. Rod tip straight under. Again, Tommy Pickering saying, don't move the feeder. It's similar to a method in that, obviously it's gone down dead quick. We don't want to be moving it, because then pellets will start to break out really quick. In fact, I'm going to show you in a bit the breakdown time, and you can obviously change it. You can put little bits of ground bait in so it breaks out even quicker, or you can like really mould it so you can get like a little slower breakdown. I think that would be quite interesting for you lovely folks to see. And we're just going to put a slight bend in that rod, and away we go. So what I can be doing now, waiting for that fish, I can be doing my next one up. So I mould my pellets in. You see, just loading it like a feeder, just moulding them pellets in there, and then I can be putting the corn on here with my little spiker. So you can see that's my up length there, 16 kkm. Got a little spiker on. You getting in on that, Joe? He's doing it. Ah, zoom! He zoomed in. Do you want to see it on there? Is that better? Yeah, so we've got that on. So it's choosing. I mean, you could put double corn on, treble corn, but I like to, let me show you. I'm going to show you now. I like to choose a bigger bit of corn, go through the soft bit so that that's sticking out of the hard bit. So we'll have that bit of corn there. So quite a long bit of corn. Go through the soft bit at the bottom, come out through the top. So it's like that. Look at that. But as I say, you could put like, I thought I had a big tight sake then. You could put like 2 or 3 bits of corn on there because it's quite a long hairy, but I'll just, I don't know, it's personal preference again. I'll just like doing it that way. And then we can do this business again. We can get the spiker thing in. Always looking down on that. As I say, preparation. So you imagine how quick this will be in a match. If you've got like 3 or 4 of these on your go and you're getting quick bites, you can come back, unhook the fish, welly him in your keep net, get your other up length on, and away you go. That's better. I was doing it wrong way around last time, so I kept falling out. Look at that. How much quicker that is. Bring that down. Tease it out with your little finger. And there you go. It's good to go for the next cast. Give it a try, folks. You'll love it.